Hello everyone and welcome to the Westfield FFA Cup Round 3 clash here at Lawton Park. And we are on Saxon Productions to bring you Langwarrin versus North Melbourne Athletic. This is Langwarrin's first game in the Cup this year after being seeded through because of their State League 1 status. And our opponents today, North Melbourne Athletic, they have got through themselves two rounds with a Round 1 3-0 victory over Moonee Valley Knights and a Round 2 3-2 victory over Riversdale. So they're on a little bit of a cup run and they fancy themselves as a giant killer. So we'll have a quick run through of the teams before we get started today. And starting for the home side, much changed home side from the tail end of last season. And starting in goals, number 1 Robbie Axe, number 2 Stephen Dick, number 4 Kieran Kenny, number 9 Matt Locke, number 10 Lewis Foster, number 11 Aaron Curry, number 8 Paul Speed, number 13 Boris Ofson, number 14 Nabil Mozafarudin, number 16 Alex Metcalf, and number 19 Connor Daly. And on the bench for the home side today, returning after a trip overseas, is number 15 Caleb Nichols, number 7 Ahmed Suleiman, number 18 Callum Kayath, and number 21 our subkeeper James Foster. And starting for North Melbourne Athletic, number 1, Liam Carolan, number 4, Carl Anton Harms, number 12, Sean Daly, number 16, Patrick Manusso, number 26, Jamie Carolan, number 34, Patrick Ryan, number 41, Ehiji Osagiel, number 50, Takayuki Hakio, number 65, John Hartson, number 75, Paul Beavis, number 85, Tom Stevenson. And on the bench for North Melbourne Athletic today, number 38, Chris Beggs, number 8, Colin Wayne, number 9, Chris Kiriakou, number 6, Adam Lambert, and number 77, Joseph Lang. For those of you who are watchers of Langwarrin matches regularly, you may not be familiar with North Melbourne Athletic. They are a team that started only 10 years ago and the Vic Soccer Federations formed out of a group of Victory fans looking for some football to play on a Sunday. They have risen through the Vic Soccer ranks and also joined FFE and risen through their ranks as well with a promotion from State 5 to State 4 last year. And we are almost underway in the first competitive fixture for Langwarrin here on Saxon Productions as we bring you Westfield FFA Cup Round 3 action. As the referees do their final checks of the nets to make sure we are good to go. And it will be Nabil Mozafarudin to get us underway. Obviously the new laws of the game as well means we don't have to kick it forwards. And this is the first time State League clubs will be using that new law. A couple of new laws as well that we may have to touch on should they happen. As we are just about to get underway, Mozafarudin to take the kickoff. Ref counts the players. And we are underway in the first competitive match for Langwarrin here on Saxon Productions. It is Westfield FFA Cup, Round 3 action. And it's a State 1 side aiming for NPL promotion up against North Melbourne Athletic, the recently promoted State 4 side. Locke spreads it wide to Metcalf. Metcalf plays it through the middle. Lewis Foster. wide. Aaron Curry starting on that left wing. A few new attacking options here for Langwarrin this year. Players like Metcalf and Curry on the wings. And it looks like Nabil Mozafruddin will be the man to lead the line at the front. Cleared by Stevenson. Option. Ball played out wide to Dick. Back to Kieran Kenny. Dick plays Metcalf, just a touch too long. Ball played through, trying to find Osagiel. Robbie Axe getting his first touch. The ball's played through towards Mozafruddin. Just a little bit too much. And Liam Carolan collects that one easily. I'm sure they will be in no rush in this game. North Melbourne Athletic looking to frustrate the State 1 team for as long as they possibly can. And route 1 for Carolan. Easily dealt with by Kieran Kenny. Ball nodded on, played straight back out for a North Melbourne Athletic throw. Locked with the clearance, finds Mozafruddin. Goes a little further back than what he originally intended, back to Stephen Dick. Metcalf. Langwarrin in no rush here, looking to probe and find the right space. The ball does eventually make its way to Metcalf. Through to Mozafruddin. Dick. Paul Speed. Switches it across to Ovchin. Ovchin takes on one, takes on two. Feet taken away from them there. And Paul Speed was possibly looking for the quick free kick. Second thoughts about that one. And it looks like be Metcalf fancies his chances from here. Metcalf. And a little bit disappointing. Not sure if that was a cross or it was meant to go towards Matt Locke. But either way, Liam Carolan in the North Melbourne goal, untroubled. Up towards Hakeel. Dick wins the header, puts it out for the North Melbourne throw. Takayuki Hakeel leaves it for Patrick Minuso. Dick with the win in the air again. A little bit of head tennis before it is eventually brought down. And then cleared by Metcalf. Finds Paul Speed. To put it out left towards Curry. First touch, a little bit behind him. Tries to cut inside Paul Beavis. But defender managed to shift it to the side. And a free kick was not given. One in the air by Ovchin. And the referee overruling the linesman here. Ovchin. Cuts it back to Speed. Speed aims directly for Metcalf on the right hand side. There'll be enough on this. Metcalf with a low cross. And Mozafruddin just a couple of yards too far back from that one. Stephen Dick to take the throw, looking for options. Moza Fruden presents. Tries to hold the ball up, wins another throw. Again, Stephen Dick looking for options. Finds Paul Speed. As cleared. The ball was played forward by Harms, but to no avail as Kieran Kenny stepped in. Again, Ovchin choosing to switch it at the back rather than the front. Cross in by Alex Metcalf. Connor Daly couldn't quite get there. Lewis Foster. Speed. Out to Dick. And Metcalf just a little bit too far in front of him. A little bit of rustiness there. Alex Metcalf, ex of Bradford City in England, has now found himself in the southeastern suburbs, the peninsula suburbs of Melbourne, aiming for NPL promotion. Manusso with a throw. Won by Speed. Harms winning the second ball. It's gone out towards Curry on the left wing. And good defending there by Jamie Carolan. He aims it towards Osagale. That's not a good look for Kieran Kenny. As he's gone down. Not sure if that was a kick or if it was a muscle injury. But he certainly pulled up pretty lame very quickly. Kieran Kenny spent a little bit of time with his youth at Liverpool and then was at Macclesfield before coming to Australia via the Swedish second division. And it's not good looking signs for Kieran Kenny here. He is getting back on his feet. Not sure if that was a knock in the challenge from, or if it's, it looks like it'll be a substitution straight away. And they are making that sub straight away. That'll be Kieran Kenny. That's the end of his game. And it looks like it's Callum Kayath coming on, otherwise known as CK. And this will mean a reshuffle. And that is not good news for Lang Warren. The starting centre half injured 10 minutes into the first competitive game. Ball's cleared. Moza Fruden gets on the end of it. He's looking for some support. He's got Curry behind him. Ball's going inside. Connor Daly. North Melbourne Athletic throw. Won by Speed. But knocked out for another throw. Lang Warren throw. Towards Kayath. Metcalf goes straight towards Connor Daly. He does get the luck of the bounce and manages to get out towards Aaron Curry. Curry now back towards Daly. Flicked on. Ball's going through the middle. couldn't quite make its way to Moses Rudin. Lock. Gets it back from Kayath. Speed takes it in the middle. Tries to look forward, looking for options. Kayath. Yeah, no surprise here, North Melbourne Athletic, who almost won the ball on the counter-attack there. No surprise here, they're packing the midfield and packing the defence, trying to make it very hard for Lang Warren to play through. And if you're going to be a giant killer, that's generally the way to do it. Lock. Finds Stephen Dick, who looks like he's swapped to the left-hand side of defence. Matt Locke has dropped into the centre of defence. And Kayath has gone out to right back. A ball, well, he slipped as he's hit that one. There's Alex Metcalf. Dick wins the header, but unable to keep it in. Throw taken down towards Osagiel. And just kept in there by Tom Stevenson, but won eventually by Stephen Dick, who's found Connor Daly. He's gone route one for Moses Rudin, who is on his own up there. Some help eventually comes. The ball's across from Aaron Curry. Was looking for Metcalf. Paul Speed throwing his body in there. And still keeps the ball in. And I think we'll call that a misplaced cross rather than a shot. Caroline with a goal kick. One by Locke, strong in the air. Ball out towards Hakeel. A little step over, trying to get past Alex Metcalf. Eventually runs it out of play. Ball played out towards Aaron Curry. Looks for Foster in the middle. And one back by Osagiel. Ovchin brings it down. Cheeky little flick over his own head. Kayath. Good pressure there by Sean Daly. Sean Daly has scored in both of North Melbourne Athletic's Westfield FFA Cup matches to date. Getting himself one against Moonee Valley Knights and against Riversdale. Wouldn't he love to make that three in a row? Ball one in the air by Locke. Dropped down to Tom Stevenson, but seen out by Lewis Foster. A little bit of holding there on Moses Fruden. Well, 15 minutes in, I don't think North Melbourne will be too unhappy with their start against a team three divisions above them. Smosa Faruden finds Locke. Metcalf, quick flick through, finds Speed. Speed takes the shot, and it's fumbled by Carolan. But he eventually gathers, and as quick as that, the ball from Matt Locke to Metcalf, and a lovely quick flick through. Almost had Speed opening the scoring. Robbie Axe finds Dick on the left hand side. And missed control by Lewis Foster. That's a recovery there by Lang Warren defenders. Well played through towards Connor Daly. And defender just got the foot in there. And Carolani's looking for options. It's going towards Takeyuki Hakeel, but Callum Kaya has done enough. Foster finds Daly. He's got Curry to the left hand side, and that's who he uses. And good defending. Curry tried to cut him inside and out, but Paul Beavis too smart for that. Deep ball in, dealt with easily by Hakeel. And Paul Speed on Sean Daly there. Sean Daly seen that one coming. Free kick by Hartson. And the nutmeg by Hakeel. Kayath tries to recover, and it's up to Matt Locke to clean it up, and he does so, playing the ball out. Connor Daly out towards Aaron Curry. They've got North Melbourne on the back foot, and again Paul Beavis winning that one-on-one battle. Ovchin out to Kaya. Metcalf. Well played back to Locke. Speed. Quick 1-2. He's found himself a bit of space, and again, heading towards Curry on the left hand side. Deep ball in towards Moses Faruden, and it's over the bar. Defender done enough there. But that might be the option for Aaron Curry, rather than trying to get the better of Paul Beavis. Start looking for Moses Faruden, because he's got the height in there to win that battle. Only a couple of weeks away from the start of both clubs' respective season, with Lang Warren away to Moorabbark on the first Saturday night in round one, and North Melbourne heading towards Altona North for their first State 4 game in their history. Speed, header knocked down towards Foster. Daly out towards Curry. Speed with overlapping run, he's got some space towards Daly. Daly takes a shot, and well, there wasn't a lot of power behind it, but it did seem to have Carolan worried. Just goes wide to the right hand side. And you feel like Lang Warren are knocking on the door now. Kayath. Mick. And that's to knock the ball down. I think Stephen Dick is down injured. Must confess, I missed that one. Not sure if he's been winded or... Well, that's not the start Gus McLeod would have wanted after losing a centre half. having another defender be down with injury. May have just copped a hit in the back. And the referee allowing a drinks break. It does look like Stephen Dick will be okay to play on. The draw for the next round, whoever goes through here, is on Monday the 13th, 12:30. You can see that live on the Football Federation Victoria Facebook. And whoever gets through here, well, they're in the draw for the next set of big boys with the NPL clubs coming in at round four. So, a chance for Lang Warren to test himself against a level they want to be at in the next couple of years. Or it could be a chance for North Melbourne to take the giant killer status to a whole other level. But plenty of football to be played today before we get to that point. And it'll be Hakeel with a throw to get us back underway. And sportingly played back to Robbie Axe after the injury to Dick, who happily is back on the pitch. Kayath back in towards Locke. Foster out to Stephen Dick. Aaron Curry with a quick turn, nice feet, and the 1-2 with Conor Daly. Curry's got the pace to get around, but again just fails to get past. Dick with a throw. Goes back towards option, and Kayath makes himself an option to spread the play. Finds Polk speed. Out towards Metcalf. Metcalf tries to cross it in, wins a corner. And a real chance to put some pressure on here for Lang Warren. Conor Daly, the man to take the corner kick. He's swinging in. He's got some targets in there with Matt Locke and Nabil Mozafarudin. Ball goes towards the back post. Almost won by Locke. Ovchin gets the header. And head and hands, he knew he had the chance there. And quick goal kick is taken. But just too quick for his own team there was Liam Carolan. Ball finds its way through to Curry. Daly. Speed. Speed finds Curry on the edge of the box, just inside. I think he wasn't sure there whether to go in or out. Sorry, that was Metcalf. Foster wins the throw in, trying to play it back to Stephen Dick. Of course, Lewis Foster's younger brother, James, is the reserves keeper here at Lang Warren. The ex-Dundee City NPL player, seeking to get himself back to that level through Lang Warren. Daly looking for the hands in the back there, but I don't think that's going to be given. I don't think either coach would be unhappy at this point in the game, 25 minutes in. Plenty of chances for Langwarrin, should keep Gus McLeod happy. And North Melbourne, well, they've been resolute in defence so far. Carolyn's goal kick just finds Daly. Daly skips past one, skips past two. Ball goes out to Metcalf, who's now switched wings with Curry. Matlock nods it on. Ozagahill tries to find Sean Daly, but doesn't quite get through. Ovchin then finds Paul Speed. Aaron Curry now on the right hand side. Finds Moses Rudin. Back to Speed. Speed going forward towards Connor Daly. And the idea was there for the flick on. Just a little bit too much height on that from Paul Speed. Ball played down the wing to no avail. And that'll go out for a goal kick to Robbie Axe. Lock. Kayath finds Moses Fruden. And want to go back to Kayath, but just missed out. Speed cleans up. Out towards Metcalf on the left hand side. Foster. Curry in plenty of space, gets across in, there's Matt Curry, and ball drops down for Metcalf. Metcalf, what a save from Liam Carolan. Wouldn't have mattered. Flag has gone up for offside as the ball went through, but after the header wasn't won by either Daly or Moses Fruden, ball drops to Metcalf. Metcalf has a fantastic strike at it, even though it was offside. Liam Carolan still produced the goods. And you don't need to see the offside flag in a highlight show for Carolan. Nodded on by Hakeel. Kayath in a physical battle there. Does come out of that with a goal kick. Thought it may have been a corner. Stephen Dick. Foster. Moses Rudin. Ball played through to Conor Daly. Conor Daly gets through one on one. And again, Carolan stands tall. He went down, but made himself big enough that it couldn't be flicked over him by Connor Daly. And this time it certainly did count. Metcalf. Back to Daly. Back out to Metcalf on the edge of the box. Metcalf fancies a shot, takes a shot, and scores! Alex Metcalf on his competitive debut. Puts the ball in the back of the net. 1-2 from the corner with Connor Daly. And just far enough to the right-hand side of the post that Liam Carolan could only get a hand to it to push it in. And that's Langwarrin 1, North Melbourne Athletic 0. The question being now, will this be floodgates or will this be enough to motivate North Melbourne Athletic? They can't park the bus for too much longer now. They're going to have to score a goal if they want to get through to round 4. It did take half an hour for Langwarrin to break down the resolute defence of North Melbourne. Something they can hold their head to. Speed. Foster. Driving forward. He was looking for Moses Rudin. Caught a little bit flat-footed there. Won by Kayath. Matt Locke steps out. Conor Daly. Looking to find Metcalf. Metcalf takes another shot. Well, maybe a touch overconfident after the goal was Alex Metcalf. Ovchin. Lot with Lewis Foster to bring it out of defence now. Connor Daly out towards Metcalf, just a little bit too much on it. And you can understand North Melbourne's want to go route one and just get the ball up there, but they're not winning it, and it's coming straight back at them twice as quick. North Melbourne throw. Finds its way through to Osagiel. Couldn't keep it under control, and the ball's now spread out wide towards Aaron Curry. Back to Kaiath and back to Locke. Certainly no rush to build up here, Langwarrin. Like to keep the ball. Certainly a noticeable change of. Still, as the ball's flicked in. Again, Alex Metcalf has looked very dangerous to switching wings with Aaron Curry and having that flexibility of wingers like Metcalf and Curry, who can play either side, will certainly make it difficult for any opponent at State League One level or any other level for that matter. There is certainly a noticeable willingness to keep the ball and make sure every single pass counts this season with the new players and slightly new style for Langwarrin. Ovchin finds Kaiath under pressure immediately from Hakeel. Does well to use his body. Curry back to Kaiath, back to Locke. Again, very comfortable on possession, Langwarrin. Ball goes through to Moza Faruddin. Makes its way through, but back to Foster. Metcalf on the wing. Dick overlapping. Gets the cross in, but it is cleared. And deep ball in towards Moza Faruddin. Manusso gets it away, but only as far as Curry. Pressure really mounting. And slightly released by Curry's rather wild effort towards goal. Minutes to go to half time. Goal kick again, won by Locke. It's probably happened five or six times already. Metcalf back winning the ball and gives away the free kick. Maybe a little bit too handsy there. The free kick is taken towards Hakeel, but dealt with quite easily by Speed. Speed goes direct to try and find Moza Faruddin. Then Carolan very quickly off his line. Almost loses his hat in the process, but does get there before Moza Faruddin. And up towards Sean Daly. But well over him, and Ovchin gets it back to Robbie Axe. Dick. Matlock plays it out to Kaiath. Is it in towards Speed? Foster. Ovchin. Finds Kaiath in some space. Connor Daly dropping deep to get the ball. Miscontrol there from Ovchin. Let's Carl Anton Harms play the ball forward, but Sean Daly was never getting there. Stephen Dick towards Metcalf. Moza Faruddin finds just a little bit of space on as he tries to put the cross in. Well defended, it will go for a corner though. And Again, looks like it'll be Conor Daly to take it. Finds Metcalf. Back to Daly. Swings it in towards Locke. And caught at the second attempt by Liam Carolan. And that's the fourth or fifth kick out from the keeper that's basically found touch. Lock. Kayath. Speed with the quick feet. Comes in, finds Foster. Again, very comfortable taking possession in tight areas, Lyne Warren. And all the way back to Robbie Axe. Kayath. In towards Locke. And they've bought themselves that little bit of space they need to get out. Locke has gone direct towards Metcalf. Gets there, Metcalf with a wonderful flick over his head, finds Conor Daly on the edge of the box. Daly weaves through one, weaves through two, takes a shot, saved, and it's in by Nabil Moses-Rudin. Well, that was unorthodox to say the least. The shot came in from Daly, it was saved by Carolan, and then diving and contorting Nabil Moses-Rudin does double the lead and makes it Lyne Warren 2, North Melbourne 0. Well, yes, I think unorthodox probably is the word for that. He may not score any stranger goal this season, Nabil Moses-Rudin. But, as they say, it doesn't matter how they get over the line, as long as they get over the line. And that's 2-0 going towards half-time. Manusso aims for Daly and Matlock shepherds it back to Robbie Axe. Foster to the left hand side, finds Stephen Dick. Metcalf, cheeky flick towards Dick, but didn't quite work out. Played forward again, searching for Daly. Does get a touch back in. And towards Hakeel, good first touch. Couldn't find Daly again though. Aaron Curry does keep it in, but only straight to the left back, Manusso. Stevenson back towards Harms. And Stevenson. Well, Harms does here on the free kick there off Curry. This would be a welcome bit of respite for the State 4 side. It'll be Manusso to take it. Harms has gone up and it's gone towards there, but just a bit over him. Ovchin wins the defensive header and Metcalf with a flick in the volley, which I think was aimed for Curry. Well won by Moses-Rudin though. Daly protects the ball out to Kayath. Ball speed. Speed. Aims it towards Metcalf and gets there. Well controlled. Back to Stephen Dick. Dick swings the ball in towards Moses-Rudin. It's gone too far. As North Melbourne look to break down the left-hand side. Not many options going forward for Tom Stevenson. So he does turn back inside and look for Harms. Harms gets it down the left-hand side, but no one moving for him. And Robbie Axe brings it out. Daly. Just too much on that for Moses-Rudin, I think. And it will go out for a goal kick. And handball there from Locke. I think just caught on a Wales after the header from Stevenson. But free kick given. And we've got the big boys up now. Harms and Hartson at the back. And you assume that's what's going to be aimed. Floated in towards the back post. Harms gets up. And he wins the header, but it does just go down well straight towards Axe, whose release was less than convincing. And a little bit of pressure here from North Melbourne. Which gets the North Melbourne fans having a little bit of attention towards the team. Hartson. Floated in towards Harms, looping header, and it's just touched onto the bar by Robbie Axe. And that's two shots from Harms in the last 60 seconds. Really putting the pressure on. As Paul Beavis starts to come down the right hand side. Quick throw again, they're looking to pull on pressure. Ball drops, shot's taken, and Robbie Axe holds it pretty safely, but it was a good shot by Tom Stevenson. But the counter attack straight away. Conor Daly finds himself inside the box. Conor Daly slots it, and again, good save by the keeper, Liam Carolan. Made himself wide again and managed to put that out for a corner. But that's how dangerous Lang Warren are looking on the counter attack as well. Noticeably, that was a little spell of pressure for North Melbourne Athletic. Well, they had put both centre halves by the looks of it up front for a couple of free kick attempts. But that does come with some risk. Metcalf to Daly. Daly finds Metcalf again. Metcalf's going to have another shot. And he does aim it towards the top right hand corner. Sails over harmlessly this time. But you've got to ask the question of North Melbourne. That's the fourth time you've let Metcalf do that since he scores from that angle. Goal kick taken. Maybe a slight nudge in the back there by Paul Speed, but he does win the header. And superb tackle there from Tom Stevenson to win possession back. And Paul Speed with a foul there. Maybe made a little bit much of that, did Carl Anton Harms. Patrick Manuzzo. And that will seal comfortably into Robbie Axe's hands. Just wasn't enough curve on the ball to cause him any worry. And won by Harms against Ovchin. Speed deals with the second ball. And Foster keeps it under control. And now Stephen Dick with Metcalf on the left-hand side. Lewis Foster finds Conor Daly. Threads it through to Moza Faruden flicks over to the right hand side. Aaron Curry takes the shot and somehow managed to be kept out by Liam Carolan. It went through his legs but bounced upwards, and he did react quick enough to keep the ball out of the net, and it goes straight towards Takeyoshi Hakil, but dealt with by the Lang Warren defence, not so much by Foster there, and slight high foot. Metcalf. Lewis Foster sees Kayath on the right hand side. Little slip. May have cost him a couple of yards there. Aaron Curry turns into Manuso. Curry with a throw. Long throw. Finds Moses Faruden. Doesn't go for the second ball, but it finds its way almost back to Aaron Curry. Kai Athanasiou, and the ball has gone out. And a few of the North Melbourne fans are unhappy with the lateness of that call. I think, to be fair, the referee called it early. But the linesman called it early, and the referee has just never seen as it's nodded back through. And Stephen Dick on the left-hand side again. Finds Daly. Shoot out to Metcalf. And a lot of 1-2s to buy a little bit of space in this line warden midfield. Well played through to Speed. Speed flicks it on. Connor Daly turning shots. And well defended by Harms and Hartson. Foster. Physical battle. Does lose out to Sean Daly. And a cheeky little back heel there by Jamie Carolan. Paul Speed. He was aiming for Aaron Curry. Never quite made it through. But it does get there eventually. Through a tackle again by Paul Speed. Aaron Curry looks like he's winding up for a long throw. Aiming for Daly or Mozafarudin in the box. It's towards Daly. And he may be strong, but that strength's not going to buy him 7 or 8 inches in height against the two centre-halves. He will wander over and take the corner. Daly towards the back post. Matlock. And referee calls half time as the corner is kicked. It is half time here at Lawton Park with the scores Langwarrin 2, North Melbourne Athletic 0. Welcome back here to Westfield FFA Cup Round 3 clash between Langwarrin and North Melbourne Athletic. It is 2-0 to the home side as we are just about to find ourselves underway in the second half here on Saxon Productions. As linesman gets himself sorted. And we are underway. Speed to Foster. Finds Connor Daly. Comes back out to Metcalf, who's found himself back on the right hand side again. Matt Locke. Play through to Paul Speed. Ball played quickly through by Metcalf. Just a touch too much for Mozafarudin. And cleared by Boris Ovchin. Again, that slight change to the back four after Kieran Kenny's injury. He was carrying an injury throughout the week. that quad injury. Did see him get taken off after only 8 minutes. And Matt Locke, a little bit of a sore one there. And Sean Daly, well, it's a free kick to North Melbourne Athletic. I thought Sean Daly may have kicked Matt Locke there, but referee seen otherwise, and it is a free kick, and it is a chance for North Melbourne Athletic. They had a couple of chances from a set piece in the first half, and it's definitely where it looked most dangerous. With Captain Harms up front, he has been looked after by Matt Locke. Manusso to swing it in. Swung in. Moza Faruddin back doing defensive duty. Paul Speed spots Aaron Curry on the run. But just not enough angle on it. And does find its way through to Liam Carolan. Carolan sprays it right. And looked like it did come off the shoulder of Jamie Carolan there, but there's a card coming out. And it looks like it's for Aaron Curry. And it will be a yellow card. I can only assume for dissent after that decision. Because it looked like he knew exactly what was coming as soon as the referee blew his whistle. And Paul Beavis will take the throw. Also a ref gets himself sorted. Throw in taken. Matt Locke wins it. Comes back to Beavis. Through to Tom Stevenson. Patrick Ryan plays it back to Carolan, who confidently chips it over Moza Faruddin. Back out to Patrick Ryan, looking for Halil, but dealt with by Ovchin. Going forward, Harms wins the header. Pressure from Foster. Fairly, according to the referee, boggles through to Moza Faruddin. Just couldn't get on the end of it. Probably enough done there by Patrick Ryan to put off the big striker. And on ball, knocked on by Ozegale. Halil putting pressure on. Robbie Axe sends it clear. Metcalf unable to gather. Harms and Manusso with an unorthodox 1-2. But it does only find its way back to Matt Locke. But one through, Sean Daly. Sean Daly takes a shot, tipped over the bar by Robbie Axe. And he found only an inch of space and managed to work a shot from that. And he has scored in every round so far, and he fancied his chances here. The eyes lit up, but well tipped over the bar by Robbie Axe. It will be a corner, and again, a chance from the set piece for North Melbourne Athletic to test the Langwarren defence. Stevenson to swing it in. Swung in. Dealt with again by Moza Faruddin, who's been diligent in his defensive duties tonight. Connor Daly walks past one, skips past two, three, but finds himself out left hand side, goes for the shot, and well, I think that's what happens when you dribble with the ball for 40 yards, you fancy yourself a shot. Goal kick by Carolan. Kayath beats Ozegale. Back towards Carolan and out again towards Musso. Well, it has gone back out for a throw to Langwarren. It will be Metcalf. He must love being switched wings to make sure he's always on the same side as the coach to get an ear bashing from Gus McLeod as the game goes on. But it will be Curry to switch over to take the long throw. Curry overlocked towards Daly. Just dropped down for Osagihil, but it was a free kick. A little bit of pushing in the box. Catalan with a free kick. And again, straight out. That's probably the fifth or sixth time the keeper's done that. To be fair, there's not a whole lot of options presenting themselves, so he is being cautious and going towards the wings. Because every time it goes through the centre, it seems to end up on Matlock's head. And then about 3 seconds later, back towards Catalan's goal. So you can understand why he's gone wide. But Moza Faruddin trying to win through. Catalan does come out and claim. And that one straight towards the camera. And looks like there'll be a sub here. And it's Caleb Nichols, notorious top goal scorer for Lang Warren, and he will be replacing, by the looks of it, Aaron Curry. And you'd think that would see Nabil Moza Faruddin head out to the right hand side, and Caleb Nichols take his normal spot up front leading the line. And with some of the service Moza Faruddin's been getting, I think Caleb Nichols will be licking his lips and he's returned to competitive football this year. Ovchin played out to Kayath, who after being under a bit of pressure in the first couple of minutes coming on, has done pretty well in defence. Moza Faruddin nudged off it. Matlock turns, finds Paul Speed. Connor Daly cut. Daly takes the shot, it bounces up. Flag is up. And offside. Well, not sure who was offside in that one. I think there's a few worried faces in green and white. That may have been a penalty call for a handball, given the way the ball pinballed around. But just safely an offside. Kayath, loose first touch. North Melbourne can't capitalise. Ball back towards Ovchin. Utilises Robbie Axe. Ovchin straight through the middle to Foster. Foster aims towards Metcalf, who has now got a rest on the ear bashing from his own bench and is now on the left hand side. Kayath. Foster. And I think he changed his mind at last minute there, Foster. Ovchin losing out on pace there, but his experience certainly seen him through. Ball comes forward towards Daly. Moza Faruddin just miscontrols it enough for Minuso to give away the throw. Foster finds Speed on the edge of the box. Speed takes the shot, and Metcalf is on the left hand side asking, what about me? Looking a touch frustrated. And I think Paul Speed has his time over again. He probably doesn't take that shot. Towards Carolan, but won by Metcalf. A little bit of support here from the North Melbourne fans. It used to be known as Trojan Athletic when they first formed. And a healthy support for a State 4 team. The ball's played through towards Moza Faruddin, but it will just run through to the keeper. Ovchin volleys it. First touch just gets away from Metcalf, who, despite being 2-0 up and comfortable, he still looks frustrated. Matlock. Neat interplay through the middle. Finds Daly. Tried to find Caleb Nichols maybe 5 years ago. Players dropping left, right and centre for Lang Warren here. As the ball makes its way through, it will end up being a corner kick. But I think there was a foul on Daly and a foul on Paul Speed. Paul Speed still limping away. Sure will be fine. And yet again, a chance of a corner, although Paul Speed has gone down with what looks like cramp in the centre of the park. And he will receive some treatment. Healthy support from the North Melbourne contingent here, otherwise known as the Trojan Athletic boys and girls. And they are giving some vocal support to their team at the Westfield FFA Cup Round 3 fixture. Corner to be taken. Swung in by Stevenson. Finds Halil! And the winger almost puts it in, gets a diving header, but just goes wide of Robbie Axe's left-hand post. And well, could have made it interesting, a goal there, and all of a sudden it's a lot less comfortable for the home side. Stephen Dick. And towards Locke. Aims out towards Kaya. Kayath, central towards Daly. He finds Nichols. Nichols out to Metcalf, back into Daly. And back out to Dick. And just a misplaced pass there. They're looking towards Sean Daly. But Ovchin, again, just gets there in time. And Matt Locke will start the attack again. Moza Faruddin towards Daly, neat little 1-2, and towards, beautiful flick there by Caleb Nichols, but just a bit too much. He's seen the run from Daly. Manuzzo cut out by Kayath, neatly played back by Lewis Foster, and Ovchin brings it out. Moza Faruddin, neat little run down the right hand side, takes a pass to Leo Manuso, deep ball in for the cross, dealt with by Harms, comes out towards Matt Locke, eyes up the shot, and does take a deflection. Don't think the shot was going in, but the deflection was enough to earn a corner for the home side. Connor Daly looking like he's struggling there. It will be Alex Metcalf to take the corner. Swung in and punched away by Liam Carolan. To Jamie Carolan. Ball played up the right hand side. Just kept in, but tackle there by Metcalf wasn't enough to stop, and they're coming forward in numbers here in North Melbourne. Ball played through towards Harms, but Callum Kayath just has enough to get there. Well, that was a full 70-yard run there by Carl Anton Harms. No wonder he didn't have the legs to keep up with Kayath in the last 10 metres. And just miscommunication there, gives away possession in a good area. Olchin. Over the top towards Mozafruden. Well, I think the referee's blown for the free kick. The free kick was definitely there. I think the groans were more so for allowing advantage. Nonetheless, play goes on. Metcalf cuts inside. Goes towards Daly. Daly gets there. Almost gets there. The goalkeeper, he's fluffed his lines a little bit there. Connor Daly decides to settle for the corner kick. And well, that looked all but Liam Carolan's ball. He just happened to miscontrol it. Gave another sniff. Daly with the corner. He'll swing it in. And towards the keeper. And he's hit the crossbar. They're asking the question if it went in. And I think the referee's saying it did go in. It's a goal. It's a goal straight from the corner from Connor Daly. Well, again, we've had some unorthodox goals today. That one's gone straight in from the corner. Looked like it got cleared out from the defender off the crossbar. And after conference with his assistant referee, Connor Daly will get the goal from his corner kick. Well, it has been anything but run-of-the-mill here when it comes to goals at Langwarrin today. But that does make it Langwarrin 3, North Melbourne Athletic 0. And just in the midst of that confusion, there has been a substitution with Nabil Mozafruden coming off and Ahmed Suleiman coming on. Affectionately known as Souza, young number 7. And we'll get ourselves back underway. We get back underway here at the Westfield FFA Cup Round 3 live stream here on Saxon Productions, as Liam Carolan did break down the right hand side, much to no avail, as Metcalf plays the ball out. Matlock. Kaya. Suleiman just overruns it. Carolan plays it out towards Patrick Ryan. He goes forward towards Osagahil. Stephen Dick. Metcalf just miscontrols it. And referee's blown the whistle, hasn't pointed which way it's going yet. And in conference with his assistant referee. And the assistant referee saying he saw it come off Metcalf's shoulder before it went over the line. Fair enough. Throw in taken. And slight handball there, I imagine, from Sean Daly. The ball's allowed to drop through, almost causing a few problems. Ovchin cleaning up. Kayath back in towards Locke. Forster playing that slightly deeper role. Axe towards Dick. And well, I think to call that agricultural would be polite. He was a little bit late, and if he escapes a booking, he can count himself very lucky, can Jamie Carolan. And I think he can. Thankfully for him, Stephen Dick rode the challenge. Silly man. Skips past one. And again, just lets the ball run out. Oh, that's going to hurt. Close range ball to the face for Callum Kayath there. Nothing malicious in it. Wrong place, wrong time as that ball hit him square on the nose. Hopefully there's no claret. Looks to be getting up okay. And a magic bottle of water sorts it all. Minuso with a free kick deep in his own half. Miss hit there, just goes straight to Metcalf. Nichols holds it up. Now turns and looks. Again, Nichols showing his experience there. Speed aiming towards Suleiman. Just a bit too much on it. The idea was good, and Suleiman acknowledges that. Midway point of the second half here. And a comfortable 3-0 lead for the home side here. Goals from Metcalf, Daly, and some part of Nabil Mozafarudin's body. I'm not sure where it came off last. We think possibly his foot. Quick free kick taken. Looking for Jamie Carolan, he acknowledges he should have been there, but he wasn't. And it just drops easily for Stephen Dick. Ovchin. Kayath. Foster finds speed. Sells a dummy to Carolan, and then gets the ball to Daly. Daly finds Nichols. Neat little touch through to speed. Ovchin calmly back to Robbie Axe. Foster finds Metcalf, who puts it forward towards Caleb Nichols, but the ball was too straight. Carolan. Cheeky little nutmeg on Stephen Dick. Harms up against Metcalf. And Harms, I think, just running out of legs. And you think that might be a sign of how the last 20-odd minutes is going to go. And again, referee taking his time to get to the decision. And needless to say, you make one decision and the ball will go out the opposite way about 10 seconds later. Matt Locke. Good turn by Caleb Nichols. Finds Suleiman on the right hand side. Kayath inside towards Foster. Finds Metcalf. Locke to Dick. Locke. Foster in a bit of space. Finds Suleiman on the right hand side. Stands up, goes inside. But just lost possession. Pure numbers. As Tom Stevenson breaks forward. He's got Matlock for company. And the side safest option is back to Patrick Manuzzo. And well, Carolan's distribution certainly leaves a little bit to be desired. Speed. Finds Lock. And one through by Kayath. Finds Suleiman. Tries to halt his own progress. Going a little bit deeper. Metcalf. Good defending there by Harms. And Jamie Carolan. Well, he seemed to have an eternity to put that ball under control. But it does go out for a throw in. And again, Matlock looks to start the attack. Suleiman. Daly. Steps inside, takes the shot. And comfortably held by Liam Carolan. Ball played through towards Sean Daly. Just numbers one out there between Speed and Foster, and Speed takes the ball away. Neat touch from Nichols. Speed finds himself in a lot of space. Goes for the cheeky little chip over towards Daly. The idea was right, the execution just a little bit off. And Carolan's giving the ball straight to Suleiman. Foster. Nichols gets it back to Foster. Finds Stephen Dick. Locke. Almost finds its way through. Gets its way through to Metcalf. And I don't know if the slip of the shot came first. Either way, it ends up 10 metres over the line. As we head into the last 15 minutes. Substitutions here for North Melbourne Athletic. Patrick Manuso going off. And we are going to have a drinks break as that happens. Self proud North Melbourne Athletic. I don't think there's been, certainly haven't been embarrassed. There's certainly been a few teams have came here in pre-season and walked away with a fairly big scoreline against them. They've packed themselves tight. I think their own distribution of the ball is probably what's cost them to this point. But it is the magic of the cup. You never know, a cheeky goal now, 15 minutes, could make the State 1 team nervous. We have our last drinks break of the game. Temperatures hovering around that 30 degree mark early in the season. I'm sure the players are certainly welcoming that little bit of break and a little bit of fluid intake. As we get ourselves just about back underway, everyone's had some refreshments. So look for this last 15 minutes of the game. And Chris Kiriakou has come on up front for North Melbourne. Looks like Sean Daly's made way. And gets in the action straight away, putting pressure on Borisovchin. Balls out to Kayath. Suleiman. New sub. Colin Wayne just come on. Plays the ball forward. And I think they have replaced Sean Daly and Patrick Manusso. Stephen Dick. Neat little touch. Finds Caleb Nichols. He's in some space. Cuts inside. Takes the shot. And well, it's gone a little bit wide there. Caleb Nichols, he done the hard part. Got into the space, cut inside. Just couldn't find the target with the shot. Chested back by Daly to Foster. Gets his way through to Nichols. Tries to nudge it on towards Daly. Ball play forward and won by Ovchin. Stevenson. Kayath finds Daly. And slight miscommunication there. I think he thought Nichols was going wide, but he stayed central. Daly gets a chance to recover though, and puts it back to speed. Suleiman, cheeky little touch, puts it towards Daly. Speed, fancies the shot, takes the shot, saved by Liam Carolan. Fantastic save there. That was net bound, definitely. Metcalf, and again, Liam Carolan. Well, the gloves are getting a workout. And that's two good, comfortable stops from both Paul Speed and Alex Metcalf in the space of 10 seconds. Back to Matt Locke. Nichols dropped it to Speed. Back out to Locke, who finds Stephen Dick. Stephen Dick fancies a shot! And that skims the top of the crossbar. I don't think anyone was expecting that to be as close as it was, apart from maybe Stephen Dick himself. He backed himself and almost scored the screamer. Carolan, of course, as all keepers do, made it look like he knew it was going over the whole time. Okay. One through. Sent through for Kiriakou. Can he keep it in? Just out. Certainly got a bit of speed, Kiriakou. Foster. And only clears it as far as substitute Chris Beggs. As the ball just trickles out there for Langwarren to throw. Daly, back to Kayath. He's looking for Nichols. Neat turn inside. A good defending back from Ahmed Suleiman. Carol Ann. Question asked for the handball. It was more ribs than hand. A little bit of sustained time in Langwarren half here for North Melbourne. Looking to keep possession. Neat turn from Carol Ann, but just numbers outdid him. But he does get the ball back inside the area. Cuts it across. And Ovchin does get the clearance over his own goal. Well worked there from North Melbourne Athletic. Managed to find Carol Ann a little bit of space on the right hand side. And again, they well fancy themselves from the set pieces. It'll be substitute Chris Kiriakou to take it. Kiriakou puts it in, harms. Well, talk about being in harm's way. You don't want to be in harm's way when he's coming through to head a ball. And throw-in will be taken by Callum Caiaf. Matches at this time of the season tend to find that slowness in the last 10-15 minutes of the game, especially in a hot day like today. Everyone's just getting the legs ready, and absolutely right on cue, Connor Daly has a little bit of cramp. Matt Locke helping him to relieve that. As he gets up, it's never fun. Connor was very forthright in why he's here when interviewed by Saxon Productions' own Jonathan Webb in the pre-season, and said he's here for one reason, and that's to win the league. So if he can do the one thing he set out to do, there'll be a lot of people, a lot of happy people around Lawton Park. And again, Jonathan Webb of Saxon Productions, who is making this possible, the live stream here from Lawton Park of the Westfield FFA Cup. As we get back underway without Conor Daly. So Langwarren temporarily down to 10 men. Matt Locke. Stephen Dick, just careless pass there, gives the ball to Jamie Carol Ann, then goes in to win it. Well, he certainly didn't. Jamie Carol Ann certainly was going to know he was there after that challenge. Maybe a touch of frustration. Conor Daly has rejoined us, but again, fancy himself in the set piece. Looks like it'll be Paul Beavis to take it. Swings it towards arms. Won by Metcalf. Good strength shown by Caleb Nichols. And just striding away from the defender is Caleb Nichols. Turns, cuts inside, cuts it back, and again, just unable to get the ball either in the back of the net or back to Alex Metcalf. Good strong run from the big striker. Axe. Lewis Foster drives through the middle. Matt Locke. Stephen Dick. And Langwarren comfortable just holding on to the ball now. As he plays the ball through for Conor Daly, and the flag is up. And Conor Daly won't be thankful for knowing the flag wasn't up till a little bit later. I think when the cramp starts hitting in, any type of run you can avoid, you will try and avoid. As we look to get a replacement ball. Free kick taken and straight to Kayath. Suleiman just nudged off the ball. And the free kick is given. Conor Daly finds Paul Speed. Neat little touch from Nichols. Daly gets through again. Daly turns, has the shot. It is blocked. And North Melbourne fancy themselves here with a counter-attack. Ball's played through towards Kiriakou. He gets there. Will he be able to keep it in? Well, strength shown there by Foster. And I think that's all it will be. There'll be no penalty there despite the shouts from the North Melbourne fans. And who can blame them? Tackle put in there by Suleiman, but it will go out for a North Melbourne throw. One by Kayath, knocked on by Speed. Ball played through to Kiriakou. Metcalf. Through to Daly. Matlock. Metcalf stands up his opponent, puts it out to Suleiman. He gets the cross in, ball drops. Conor Daly's going to take the shot, takes the shot, and absolutely powers it in. And his measured celebration is to stretch out that cramp. Not a bad way to seal up a match with only a couple of minutes to go. Neat work on the edge of the box. Ball played out to Suleiman on the right hand side. Looked like the cross had missed a couple of marks till it found Conor Daly at the back post. Set himself, put his boot through it. 4-0. That's his second of the day, of course. Ball played through towards Kiriakou. Just caught on his heels a little bit. Caleb Nichols. Just nudged off the ball by Karl-Anton Harms. He's done well to win it. On the left hand side, Tom Stevenson tries to get the cross in, and that's a tired cross. We've ticked over into second half injury time here. Option through to Speed. Metcalf calling for it. Finds himself with acres of space in front of him. Nichols out to the left, Daly to the right. He's going central. He fancies himself as a shot. Metcalf takes the shot and the deflection puts it in. That makes it 5-2 for Metcalf. And he's quite happy with his day's work as well on his competitive debut. Not too much Liam Caroline could have done about that one, as the shot's hit, takes off the defender's foot and sails over the goalkeeper. So that's Lang Warren 5, North Melbourne Athletic 0. Two for Metcalf, two for Daly, one for Moza Faruddin. And all of a sudden, in the last few minutes, it's looked a lot more comfortable. Obvious forwards towards Kiriakou. It was a slightly theatrical way to fall. Foul was definitely there. And you think anything now is clearly just a consolation at 5-0. Ball floated in, dealt with by Locke. Metcalf on the volley. Nichols will try and challenge for this one. Ball floated in towards Kiriakou. Gets there, drops for him, drops for Carolan. Ball crossed. And unfortunately for the North Melbourne fans, the ball is in the net, but with a flag up behind him. So, for those that like the magic of the cup, maybe a bit of a spoil sport for that. There's a discussion yet again between referee and assistant, who takes his time to wander over. Helps to have a quick chat. Not sure what is being discussed here. I think it's going to significantly change the outcome of the game. However, the North Melbourne boys certainly want to come away here with a goal. And Lang Warren want to keep the pre-season clean sheet record happening. But the goal is given. The goal is given. There is. And a fantastic chant from the North Melbourne fans of "We're going to win 6-5. Well, I'm glad I'm here if there's going to be another 5 goals scored in the next probably 2 minutes. There you go, ladies and gentlemen, that's the magic of the cup. 5-1 down in injury time. Hopeful of winning 6-5 and singing a heart out. Well done to North Melbourne Athletic. And that is the final action here at Lawton Park. Our live stream here of the Westfield FFA Cup round 4. It is Lang Warren 5, North Melbourne Athletic 1. And it is the State League 1 boys that go through to the round 4 draw, which will happen Monday 13th of March at 12:30. And congratulations to North Melbourne for the cup run to this point and getting the consolation goal. But it is Lang Warren 5, North Melbourne Athletic 1. Thank you for joining us on the live stream here on Saxon Productions. Hope to see you next time. And pay attention to Saxon Productions and Lang ETV for all future upcoming games to do with Lang Warren.